Hello, my name is Ben Afflerbach. I'm a graduate student here at the University of Wisconsin, and today we're going to be learning a little bit about machine learning and how researchers are using it to make predictions about materials. So machine learning is a modeling technique in which models learn to recognize patterns from previous observations and then use those patterns to make new predictions about materials. And for material scientists, one thing that we might want to use to make predictions about is materials properties. So one property that you might have some intuition and experience with would be transparency. So an example of a transparent material would be this plastic bottle because we can see through it, whereas this coffee mug would be non-transparent because we can't see through it. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at this list of materials and we're going to come up with our own predictions, and then we're going to compare two predictions from a machine learning model. So let's look through these materials. First, we have window glass, we have a penny, we have a smartphone screen, we have steel, water, and salt. So take a second to pause the video. If you want to write down your predictions, you can grab a pencil and paper and you can construct this same table and come up with your own predictions. And then once you have those, you can move on to the next section and we'll look at how we made those predictions and how the machine learning model is going to make those predictions. So the first thing that we want to take a second about is think about how we made those predictions ourselves. So for some of the materials, you probably had a direct observation that you've made either currently or previously about the material. So for window glass, for example, you probably had a window on hand and you might have glanced to the side and you can clearly see that you can see through it, you can see outside, and so that's a transparent material. But some of the other ones maybe you didn't have a direct experience with, so maybe you thought of a similar material in order to make your prediction. This is actually very similar to how the machine learning model works, except it can't, directly look at things. It doesn't have a camera built into it. It's not an actual, robot that's going around. Instead, what it learns from is data that we give it. So we have a data set of about 400 materials that we give it as examples to learn from, and then it's going to tell us its predictions about new materials. And the information that it has, instead of, again, like a camera that's taking a picture, is we give it a list of fundamental properties of the elements that are in each material. So if you look at the table that we had previously, you'll see that I also included all the elements that are present. And this is actually the information that's given to the model. So using these examples, or what we call the training data, the model then compares new predictions to the training data that it has, and that's how it comes up with the predictions that it's going to make. So I actually have the model on hand, so we can go look at it making predictions in real time to see how that works. So this is all written in Python code, and I've kind of made a very simple version of this model, and it actually only takes one line of code to fit or train the model. And that's what I did just there. It only took a few seconds because our data set's fairly small. And we can again also see an example of what that input information looks like for the model. So here we have one of the input features is this atomic volume. So this is the size of the elements that are in the materials that we gave it. So the model has some information about the size of the elements. It has a bunch of other properties as well. This is one that's fairly easy to kind of understand a little bit. So it has these as a numerical representation, and that's the way it's learning again these patterns to make its predictions. And then in this next line of code, we can actually tell it to make all the predictions for the materials that we have. I already wrote this out ahead of time, but we can see it has silicon, oxygen, copper. This is the phone screen. And what we have is a numerical representation and then also our classification representation as well. So I'll copy these results back to the slides and we can see what the outputs look like. So I've copied those back over here. We can see that it thought three of the materials were transparent and three of them are non-transparent. So let's compare it to what we would consider the correct values to be. So for the window glass, again, we know that that's transparent, so it's correct. The penny is non-transparent. The phone screen should be transparent because we need to see all the images that are beneath it. Steel would be non-transparent. Water would be transparent. And then salt would be transparent. So it looks like it got all of these correct except for one. It looks like it thought the smartphone screen was not transparent. So we can see in this case that the model is not perfect. It clearly has room to improve, but thankfully that's one of the things that machine learning models are really good at. We've only given it 400 examples of previous materials here. So if we give it more and more examples, it can hopefully learn these patterns better and continue to improve as it gets more data. And this is exactly the same way that you sort of learn over the course of your lifetime from observing, again, previous materials. And this is how you were able to make your predictions. So that's all I have for the activity for today. Hopefully you had a comparison to yourself versus a machine learning model. You could see how the model made its predictions, how you make your predictions, and how it can continue to improve over time by giving it more data. Thanks and have a good day.